I would say I reverted to Islam when I was around 20. When I say I reverted, this is a word that I choose specifically because half of my family was already Muslim, half of my family was more from a Christian background, and we didn't grow up into like a religious education, but around 20 years old, I reverted to Islam as I thought it was the religion that stuck more to my values and the way I wanted to see life and behave and conduct my life with other fellow human beings. And yeah, since then, obviously, it has completely changed my life and my relation with people, and yeah, so I think it's the turning point of my life when I turned to Islam. Of course, there are other people that are not Muslim that also do some charity work, and it has to be congratulated as well. But it's just that I think it's with Islam, it's just like emphasizing the good quality of people, you know. And since I reverted to Islam, of course, for me, charity was going to be part of my life. Obviously, there are also some individual trials in life, things that happen to you and make you think a little bit more about the purpose of life. But this added to your values of Islam, of course, helps you and encourage you to give more to people. First of all, I'm myself a son of the son of an orphan. My dad grew up as an orphan, and it was always his dream to one day build a facility for orphaned and vulnerable children in Mali. But also, when I was still very young, I had this idea, and I just like tried to develop this idea in my head since I was around 22, 23. It was in 2007, 1 year before I moved to Spain, to Seville, to play football. And obviously, I was looking for, like every Muslim, when you go to a new place, you try to see where you can find your halal meat and where you can find a masjid. And I found this masjid that the Islamic community, the Muslim community of Seville were using. It was a kind of a musalla. And unfortunately, in 2007, I learned that they were going to lose the facility because they were renting the place, and the owner wanted to evict them, and the only solution was to buy the property, the building actually. And so alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah, I don't get any pride out of that. It's just that I was lucky enough and to have the honor of helping them save this masjid. And alhamdulillah, until this day, they are using the masjid as the main masjid of Seville. But this is a temporary solution because there is an ever-growing Muslim community in Seville, and they need a bigger space, and they have a big project now to build the first purpose-built masjid in Seville after 700 years. Because as you know, Al-Andalus used to have a masajid and so on, but since then they never had a purpose-built masjid, and I pledged to help them raise awareness and funds to build this new masjid, inshallah. Yeah, I mean, first of all, I have to thank all the organizers. I have to thank the president for attending the event and taking the time for this beautiful event. I have to thank the Ministry of Religious Affairs, the Tukiye, the Diyanet Foundation. So it was a fantastic event, and all the organizers. And I was really touched to receive this prize. And it's always very humbling to be recognized by the work you're doing, especially when it touches to charity. I think it's very important to recognize all the people that are doing that, because it will help encourage other people to follow this path. Always, instead of always focusing on the material, on making money, on being successful in businesses, this is the best business we can do, helping other people. So again, I just want to congratulate all the organizers for this beautiful event. this event is also thanked to him, and he took the time, as I said, to come and so on. So it means a lot to him, and even took the time to discuss a little bit with me. So that was really nice. And I mean, worldwide, I think obviously you can't please everybody in life. This is impossible. But what we have to say, that we think that he's very respected, not only because he's the president, because of what he's doing as well, because he's really involved into charity, into helping people. I think Turkey is the country that helps more all the refugees, that give more to charity and so on. So I think this is, and it has a very big economic growth as well. So this proves that giving more is not taking away from you, in the opposite. And as the Quran says, that when you give, you receive more. You know, it multiplies. Charity multiplies your belongings, and that's what's happening today for Turkey. So I thank the president for taking all this initiative to bring to relieve people and help people around him.
Please tell him.
Is that a vase they are making?
Beautiful mask, mashallah.
Başarılarıyla ismini futbol tarihine altın harflerle yazdıran dünyaca ünlü bir isim. O sadece attığı gollerle değil, yaptığı iyiliklerle de Müslümanların gönüllerinde taht kurdu. Hayatını Peygamber Efendimiz'i örnek alarak sürdüren bu kişi Frederik Omar Kanaute. Kanaute, Mali asıllı bir futbolcu. O, yaptığı hizmetlerle adını iyiler kervanına yazdırmayı başardı. 20'li yaşlarda İslamiyet'i seçen sporcu, Mali sokaklarında dolaşırken gördüğü fakir çocuklardan etkilendi ve onlar için bir vakıf açtı. Bu vakıf sayesinde Mali'de yüzlerce çocuk için köy kurdu ve onların umudu oldu. Ayrıca İspanya'da bir caminin yıkılmasını engelledi. Hatta caminin bulunduğu yeri satın alarak Müslümanlara devretti.
L'idée que j'avais dans ma tête de Sakina, ça commence à se réaliser. Oui. Vraiment, j'avais vraiment l'idée d'un village le plus naturel possible. Intégrer ce projet dans un village naturel où les enfants pourraient vivre dans des familles qui ressembleraient le plus possible à une famille naturelle. Donc c'est pour ça qu'on a décidé de le construire avec plusieurs maisons assez écartées pour donner un peu d'air entre les maisons et pour qu'ils puissent vivre en communauté et dans un environnement le plus naturel possible. Donc oui, c'est un peu l'idée que j'avais imaginée et aujourd'hui ça commence à y ressembler.
İyilik, bazen Kanaute'nin yaptığı gibi bir çocuğun gözlerindeki sevince tanık olmak, bir yetimin başını okşamaktı. Bazen de aynı duaya amin demekti.